Hello, Modesto. How are you doing? Out at the intersection of 9th and I is the archway of Modesto. Water, wealth, contentment, health, all that good stuff. You ask 90% of Modestans if they have any of that in Modesto here, they'll say no.
Well, we love you, Modesto. We love you.
This is my hometown. This is where I grew up. This is where I was born. I spent about 20 years here. And so did a rather large celebrity. I think you know his name. If you don't, you know his creation. The creator of Star Wars, George Lucas, spent the first 20 years of his life going to school, growing up, and he spent it here. I'm gonna show you some of the places in Modesto where George Lucas wandered around. Let's do this. About all those things I said in the beginning, not all of them are true. Most of them are true. Most of them are pretty accurate, but not all of them. It's not a terrible, terrible place. Every place is gonna have its pros and cons. Don't know what this stands for, but it's really cool. It kind of reminds me of like a Tower of Terror setup. It's even got a cool old sign on the side of the wall here. Central Stamp and Coin Company. It's pretty awesome. Behind me is Thomas Downey High School. This is where George Lucas went to high school. It's the same school that my grandpa went to as well. George Lucas would have gone up and down this street right here behind me in his souped up Fiat to and from school. So long, Downey High. This is Roosevelt Junior High, where George Lucas went in junior high. It's also where my grandmother went to junior high. This is where George Lucas went to elementary school. All right, so I'm on the street where George Lucas had his first house. Not his first house, his parents' first house. This is where he grew up. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to actually like go up, walk up to the house. There are people across the street. They're doing some work on the house right across. I'm gonna drive by it. And if it seems okay, then I'll go ahead and I'll walk. I'll get closer. Yeah. Right up here, it's not the house with the basketball hoop, but right next to it, that one right there, that was George Lucas's house as a child. Nice boat. That house is really close to the elementary school and Downey High. It's just down the street as well. George Lucas's family lived in that house up until 1958 before they moved into their house on Sylvan Avenue. So after the first home that George Lucas was in, he would have moved to a house that was here. It's no longer here, it's just a big business complex, but he would have driven down this street almost every day from school. Just for a reference, if you were to go down this road and then turn right up there at that intersection, which is Coffee, you would go all the way down this way and get to Downey High School. So George Lucas would have drove down this road and then turned in this way to get to his home. Every day from school. This house is where George Lucas got into an almost fatal crash. That's what I've read, at least. The story goes that George had been down at the library, and as he was going down this street, he was making a left turn and was hit by another driver. So he would have been coming down this road right here, going this way, and as he was turning left to get to his parents' house, an oncoming car would have hit him right here. He was in the hospital for a few months and actually missed his graduation ceremony. So this was a pretty serious accident. And just think, if it had been any more serious, he could have been killed and there would have been no Star Wars. And people say there's no God. Back when George Lucas and his family lived here, it wouldn't have looked like this. Obviously, their house would have been here and not this complex place. However, geographically and landscaping-wise, it would have looked completely different. It would have looked something a little bit more like this. A little more like this. I have no idea if these are walnuts or whatever the heck, but it's trees, and yeah.
That's what I'm talking about. If you've seen American Graffiti, you'll recognize him.
Nice car. Check that out.
Kind of hard to read this plaque, but it says George Lucas Plaza, and in it is this wonderful statue. I didn't realize that on the other side there's a bench. I can sit here too. I can't really like sit with them, so yeah. Wonder what's on this little guy.
This is the downtown public library. This is where I came as a kid to get books. However, the original downtown library is right down here, and that's where George Lucas would have gone.
The homeless people down here are everywhere, like literally everywhere. Thank you.
That's a cool old sign. And these ones are awesome too.
Across the street from the library is the McHenry Mansion. Beautiful, beautiful old home that was built, I think, around the 1880s. And the McHenrys were some of the first inhabitants of Modesto, back when all of this was just fields and dirt roads. A little bit of history for me now, living in Modesto. Right here is where I had my first accident. An accident by me, I was driving, not an accident that I had been in with someone else. My first accident. I was coming across this way, came through this intersection, got hit from a guy going this way, and I flipped around and was facing the way that I am now, on the other side of the intersection. About to go through that intersection again. Woo! What a rush! What a rush! This is Modesto Junior College. George Lucas came here. I came here for a little while. Just a little while. My dad went here, my mom, my grandparents who went to college. Buildings, old and new. It's a pretty place. Fairly green for being in Modesto. This is actually a pretty big historical place for me as well. There's two campuses of MJC, one that's over an overpass, and then one, this is the other one. This one is really close to a lot of places that were big in my childhood and just overall life. My youth pastor's house was behind this building over there. He's the one who gave me the White Lightning, my car that I drive right now in Oregon. We used to go over to an O'Brien's Market over there. Also, there was a pizza place over there and a movie rental shop. I'm talking straight VCR. You rented VCR tapes. On this road here, I used to work at a company that was down farther, like a block away down this road. And then if you were to go all the way down that road that goes back out there, that was where my childhood home was. So that's pretty much all I got. I'm meeting my family later for a dinner. So I'm gonna have to go home and maybe freshen up so I'm ready for that. But other than that, that's pretty much all I got going on today. All freshened up, ready to go see my family and hang out. I really enjoyed going to those places, kind of getting around Modesto, since I haven't been here for a while. Also, about all those things I said in the beginning, not all of them are true. Most of them are true. Most of them are pretty accurate, but not all of them. I enjoy Modesto for what it is. Even though most of the time people are rude, mean, inconsiderate, and full of the city's dirty a lot of the times, there's crime, every place is gonna have its pros and cons. It's a constant joke that every Modestan just hates Modesto. Like, nobody likes Modesto. Modestans, people who don't live in Modesto, no one likes it. We get it, it's not the greatest place. But if you're from somewhere, then own it. That's where you grew up. It's made you who you are today. It's made me who I am. It made George Lucas who he was. If George Lucas had grown up somewhere else, Maybe wouldn't have had the inspiration to create Star Wars, definitely wouldn't have had the inspiration to make American Graffiti. As you can see, we Modestans are very proud of American Graffiti. But yeah, all in all, just, it was great. Modesto is fine. Modesto is totally fine. There are better places, but Modesto is fine. Anyway, that's the end of this one. I'm gonna go hang out with my family, and for the rest of the time that I'm here, I probably won't be filming really anything at all. Maybe just a little bit here and there. This weekend is family time. All right, glad you could tag along, friends, and I'll catch you later.
See ya!